Well, Matt, it's been a while, but you and the rest of the boys have finally returned to Fairwood. How does it feel to be back?
Fantastic, to be honest. It's a little bit of normality back to our life. So, yeah, it's brilliant to be back, to see the lads and to have a ball at your feet. It's brilliant.
Yeah, because I know you've been in regular contact during lockdown with the rest of the boys, but great to finally see them again in person and the staff, I imagine.
Yeah, well, even though you have to socially distance, it's still good to be around everyone and to hear how people are doing, to make sure everyone's all right, and just to be back together as a group. I know we're training just in groups of five, so some days you see different people, but then eventually after a couple of days you've seen everyone, all the staff are there, and yeah, it's just good to be back together.
And I understand things are a little different at Fairwood to when you were last there a couple of months ago with such strict measures now in place. Can you tell us a little bit more about that?
Well obviously the guidelines set out by the EFL and the Premier League as well that we have to adhere to. It's a little bit strange, but to be honest, the staff, the backroom staff and everyone at the club has worked so hard to put these measures in place to make sure it's safe for everyone. So we thank them massively, and it gives us a platform to get back to where we want to be, and that's on the pitch. So as you drive in, you have to have your temperature taken before every session, just to make sure that you're not running a temperature. Obviously is one of the signs of COVID. We're being tested twice a week for COVID, and then once you've had your temperature check, and that's all good, you drive around, park in your designated bay that is 2 meters apart from everyone else, and then proceed to the pitch and training, obviously staying 2 meters apart, grabbing what equipment you need, your GPS and stuff. We've been taking all our kit home, and Mike Heans have been brilliant with that. Sorted everything for us, our boots as well. So we just have to make sure that we turn up in correct kit every day, and that's literally all we have to worry about. The staff have taken care of everything else, and like I said, we thank them massively for that.
Just making sure you arrive with the correct kit, that's not a bad thing to just have to remember, is it?
Exactly. All you got to remember is your water bottle and your boots, and then everyone else takes care of everything else. So just got that to worry about, and then obviously the hard work of training.
And as you say, as we gradually ease back into things, you split into small groups. Some of you arriving in the morning and some in the afternoon. I think it's groups of five.
Yeah, groups of five. And depending on what session the staff are putting on, it will depend which group you're in. So obviously you may have a defender, midfielder, attacker type session. You may have like a group session where it's all defenders or all midfielders, etc. So like I said, it's groups of five, always adhering to the rules. But then obviously depending on what session you do, you see different people and you mix and chat to different people, so it's good to have that as well.
And maintaining a social distance during training sessions, something you'll never have experienced before, I imagine. So how have you adapted to that?
Yeah, no, I think it's been good. I think it's football at the end of the day, so even if you're doing five-a-side and possessions, non-social distancing, it's still the same as doing a passing drill, social distancing really. Having a ball at your feet and getting started again, with the end goal obviously to be back in full contact training and then eventually back into the games. So we know it's all part of the plan and all gearing us towards a restart, which ultimately is the end goal. I think the lads are enjoying it. Obviously the manager and the first team coaches as well have been fantastic, putting on sessions that we enjoy and we get a lot out of. When it can sometimes be hard when you have to socially distance, but no, it's been a fantastic start And yeah, we're really looking forward to getting going again.
And as you say, that again just highlights how much credit the staff deserve for the hard work that's gone into making sure it's as safe an environment as possible.
Yeah, well, I can't stress enough how hard they've worked over the last couple of weeks to put everything in place, from scheduling the drills to providing the right care and making sure everything's set up for our return. It's been a phenomenal effort from all the staff at the club, and the lads are very, very thankful, and we feel comfortable, more than comfortable, going back in and starting training, which I think says all it needs to.
Well, exactly. And obviously, it's still very early days. Safety is, of course, the primary concern in all of this, but just how excited are you to finally get back out there at the Liberty whenever the opportunity does come around?
Yeah, of course. Well, like I said, that's the end goal. So all the work we're doing now is building us towards that. And now we're back out and got a ball at our feet, you kind of just forget everything that's going on, to be honest. It's like I said, it's a bit of normality, and yeah, we can't wait to get going. Obviously, we have to take each step as it comes, get through each phase safely, make sure everyone's happy with it and healthy. But yeah, like you say, it's a feeling like no other, getting out and playing on a Saturday. So we want to all get back to that.